I mean,
by sort of ideological warfare, I'd say. There were kind of two sides that were competing over.
Oh yeah, we do. Yeah.
Almost like a religious war.
You put the point up to there, and then you
the
just wait a second, right?
Like computation was kind of a new form of human cooperation.
Yeah, you know what I mean? The point of the knife, the scalpel goes up
the
there.
The literary founding figure of this idea.
You have to wait for the deeply concerned nurse to mop your brow first.
A short story called The Machine Stops that envisioned the future of computer networking.
It's not an operating lab, it's an operating theater.
Describes the world we ended up with.
What he proposed is that
technology
through the operation, it's savoring the operation.
If it's thought of as something that becomes the center of things, if it becomes an object in itself,
there's acceleration
is toxic
and
destructive, and it has to be thought of as something that people do together
coming
instead.
Up and then poking in,
yeah, so it's a kind of a question of how
times,
you organize the
and then
verbs and the nouns
making a
when
nice
you think about
slice and
technology.
Yeah. Order,
and even you shouldn't allow technology.
You still like, I'm thinking it's like the real eccentric movements of
the computer was actually created. And this other idea of the computer being its own thing, sort of an entity, was kind
of
solidified by Alan Turing when he wrote the note about the Turing test
around
that you might not be able to distinguish computers from people.
That's
if you can't come up with a test to distinguish them, then perhaps you shouldn't, and you should grant the computer sort of status as another entity, as another creature. Now, the thing about the Turing test is, I suppose.
You
when
probably
I
want to find a cool
test,
prop to cut into as well.
Could have been in the
70s.
We're gonna make some coverings that are like basically like a rubber suit, like a foam rubber suit.
Is my camera not on? No, my camera's
put
on.
Over the top of the exoskeleton.
So in the 70s, we were always taught the Turing test as being kind of a straightforward philosophical thought experiment that Turing wrote.
Like,
it wasn't, as is now widely known because of a popular movie. Turing came up with the Turing test in the last weeks of his life, just before he committed suicide. And he committed suicide in sort of a strange way by eating an apple laced with cyanide in front of his computer.
What
isn't known is that even, or wasn't known, what I didn't know in the 1970s was that even
the Turing
stuff
that's super rubbery,
been celebrated
but
as one
I think
of the
you
great
use latex and actually add some sort
II,
of catalyst that causes it to foam while it hardens.
Way to use a computer to
break
a Nazi secret code, among other things.
You know, like a mold.
Turing himself was deemed as an illegal person because he was gay at a time and it was not legal to be gay, and he was forced by the British government to endure a